Fame.
Welcome to another edition of Pittsburgh Sportsline Live in the BPTV studios. It's a special night here. We started the show October 11th, 2011. Just wanted to switch the camera. You could show a cake that we got from Bethel Bakery. Can you pull in on that, Devin? Look at that. Happy 7th anniversary, Pittsburgh Sportsline. I'm going to break the rules, and I'm going to cut pieces of cake right now.
Oh, good.
I'm going to ask Devin, and we got Zach Taylor here, who's not going the gateway. We'll bring these guys in. First, I'll cut a slice for Chipper.
Oh, you know it, man.
And it's marble batter. So we got that. And, whoa, I fell over. Sorry.
Some of that marble.
Grab your
look at that
utensil. Devin, could you get a picture here?
My shirt matches the cake.
That's very apropos. And this is a live show, so we're doing this for our fans. Thank you for watching our show. We appreciate you. Here, Devin, I got my camera here. If you can get a photo with mine, because I'll post that up too. Got Smoking Jim, got a nice slice for him.
All right.
Play nice, sir.
Pass down that white icing, buddy.
It's marble. That's pit gold. They told me this is pit gold.
Throwback.
Pit gold. How about that? So we got that. Oh, I got to get a nice slice for myself. What the heck?
Machine.
Nice. Let me get a slice for Devin Shea. And we got to get Zach Taylor in on this. Here's a slice for Devin. Make sure you get a fork.
Not going to hurt your backflip, is it?
The sugar will help put a little spring in his legs.
All right, and this is in celebration of our 7th anniversary show. We're not sure. We got somewhere between 500 and 600 TV shows saved on YouTube. So let me put a little icing on there for you. Get a fork. Come on, Zach, grab a fork.
Cut a piece for his mom.
That cake will wait there. I'm stained black. This black is unbelievable. Thanks, Devin, for the pictures. Appreciate it. I need a fork here to try it. Got it.
Well, that Rockless burger with that throw.
I know. Thank you. I wound up, baby. I didn't throw too high.
That
either.
Elbow ain't bothering you tonight.
No, it hasn't. Let me take a bite of this. Huh? Thank you, Bethel Bakery.
Funny.
This is delicious. Thanks for watching all our shows on Comcast 7, only in Bethel Park. And watching other shows, Verizon 32, all the way from Nemacolin to Cranberry, Wexford, and all points in between. Special thanks for all the likes and watching our shows on Facebook. 6,779 likes, so thank you. We appreciate that. It means a lot to us. I got to take another bite. I'm sorry, folks. This is live TV, and I'm talking while I'm eating, so I know you're not surprised by that. It's just an honor and a privilege to be doing this show for 7 years. I'm proud of that. Nice to have my guys here, Chip Hayner, Smoking Jim Frazier. Chip, did you drop your cake on the floor?
No, I fell into that bottomless pit I call a stomach.
It disappeared. It disappeared. And Smoking Jim, I didn't have the white batter. I got a marble batter. I knew you could be a rule breaker tonight.
I don't even leave crumbs for the mice.
Oh, I believe it. No doubt about it. I got to try to do some promos here. Let me see what I got here. Olive Oil's Pizzeria sponsors this show. That's Frank Finera, 412-831-1900. Thank you for the pizza and the hoagie. We enjoy it, and thanks for sponsoring our show. There's a Block It Out Girls Volleyball fundraiser Thursday, October 11th at 7:30 at the Bethel Park High School. Check it out. Let me see here. They got a pregame ceremony to honor breast cancer survivors. Fundraising to include T-shirts, tickets, auction, and 50-50. All proceeds will support the Allegheny Health Network Cancer Institute Patients Assistance Fund. Contact Brenda Sotka at 412-334-6201. Here it is. Block It Out. Beat cancer. Thank you, Devin. Appreciate that. Bethel Park Historical Society, Schoolhouse Arts and History Center. They have an event this Sunday. It's a grand reopening. How could that even happen? They had a grand opening last year. They got 105 new windows. They got different things. They'll have food there. It'll be this Sunday. I'm not sure what time, but check it out on their website. I'm going to stop by there. I got invited by Bill Habether to come on out. He said, don't miss this grand reopening. I go, how do you even have it? So he'll explain. It's a great event. That's the Bethel Park Historical Society Schoolhouse Arts and History Center. They're a 501c3. Donate what you can there. They do great things in Bethel. This cake is staring me in the eye. I know how chips disappeared. I'm trying to make this. That buttercream icing.
That's good.
It's good stuff.
That's good.
Delicious. All right. We end each show with Stay Joey Strong. Poor Joey didn't make it to his ninth birthday. Joey Fabus Childhood Cancer Foundation, 501c3. Donate your money, your time. They have events all year round. Check it out. And stay Joey Strong. All right. Bethel Park Community Foundation, bpcf.org. They have money for you from $100 to $5,000 for your organization doing great things in Bethel Park. That'll help you out to help people in Bethel Park. So go to it, get the application, and then apply for money. $100 to $5,000 for your group. Go get it, bpcf.org. Thank you. Next, Dave Cable likes to have fun at my expense. Put my face on Uncle Sam. Uncle Al, the talking machine, wants you for BPTV. You could be like Zach. You could be like Devin and get a slice of cake. Once in a while, we celebrate different events. Who knows? When we find out how many shows we have, maybe we'll have a cake for 600 TV shows. We'll see what happens. I'm investigating that right now. We got over 500. I'm not sure if we passed 600, though. So it's been quite the event. But they're all on YouTube, and we want you for BPTV, 412-831-3304. You can run sound cameras, help us out here in the studio when we do the only live TV show in Bethel Park. Come out on a Tuesday night and give us some help. We appreciate it. Next, we have a sponsor, Skeets Lewandowski of What's On Your Mind. Pardon me, Skeets, I'm taking another bite. This is ridiculous. I can't stop. Cake is delicious. Well, Skeets works on anything and everything that runs on gas. I was just there today. He's always doing something. It was my pleasure to be out there, and he helped sponsor the show here with What's On Your Mind. And he does do great work on anything and everything that runs on gas. Cars, trucks, boats, weed whackers. You know, you name it, even gas trimmers, tree trimmers, gas trimmers of hedges, all these things he's worked on. I've seen it in his garage. It's amazing what he does. So check it out. You can give him a call, 724-348-4715, right past Tracks Farm in Mineral Beach. Can't miss him down on the right in Red, White, and Blue Station. Can't beat him. All right, we're going to start this show. What's on your mind, Smoking Jim Frazier?
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green,
And the eating machine.
You
here it is.
Got to see Levine. She's like Martavius Bryant, 3 catches for about 100 yards.
91.
91, about
100. One disclaimer before it gets too deep here. This guy was supposed to be the MVP of the Super Bowl. Not going to happen. Guy's supposed to be the greatest receiver in history. I'm watching a play, happen to flick on the TV. I see a great pass. He's running down the field, probably inside the 20-yard line, makes a catch. Nice catch. He fumbles the ball. The other team picks up the ball. They ended up scoring on that. Unbelievable. You can listen to Smoking Jim, but I'm dealing in reality. That's my disclaimer. Forget about Martavius Bryant.
Sometimes you get that pig all greased up. It's hard to hold it.
There was no grease on that, baby. That wasn't like your Kentucky Fried bucket of chicken, baby. Now that's some grease. Go ahead. Continue, my friend.
Well, the Pittsburgh Sports Line Team of the Week is, of course, your Gateway Gators. And I'm shocked. I never knew Franklin Regional was a rivalry of Gateway. How can a nail be a rivalry with the hammer? But disappointed in Gateway. This is probably the best team Gateway's ever had. And they just won't score after halftime.
Why is that?
You know, they build up a 56-point lead at halftime, and then they do what they call showing class in the second half and let the clock run and put the backups in. But I always feel like you should continue to run your game, because the backups had nothing to do with that 56 points. So I'm running double reverses, option passes, whatever I do with my backups. That's a different game. It's 0-0 after halftime with the backups. But, so that's the Pittsburgh Sports Line Team of the Week again. It's about the third time Gateway's in the Team of the Week this year. But
no prejudice here.
But, hey.
Season ticket holder that he is.
Yeah.
So, he don't miss a game.
Not a game.
Just look for his seat. We don't know where the seat's at. He moves around a little bit.
But
be careful.
Yeah, check for me in the press box. But, hey, I wonder. Chip, you can help me out with this. Congratulations to the Pittsburgh Pirates. How many games were they out of the wild card? It had to be pretty close.
I don't know what the final tally was, but at 82 and 79, yeah. They ended up with a winning season when nobody gave them credit.
Yeah.
For everybody thought that they would be well below 75 wins.
You're looking at maybe 4 or 5 games to get into wild card.
Basically, here's what it is: one more win a month would have put them in contention for the.
And here's what it got them to one more win a month. How about Garrett Cole pitching 12 strikeouts? With no walks. Mm-hmm. How about Andrew McCutchen tearing the cover off the ball for the Yankees.
Wait a minute. Apparently, you're not paying attention.
RBI.
What's that, like his fifth in the month? Okay, because that's tearing the cover off
leadership.
The ball.
He's leading the team.
No, he's not.
He's a leadoff hitter.
And Austin Meadows, you put those three together.
He's not even playing.
You put those three
Austin
together.
Meadows isn't
Austin
even playing.
Austin Meadows never even made it to the major league club. He's in the minor league.
You put those three together, and I think you got the Milwaukee Brewers.
Smoking Jim, who wrote this for you? Because the facts are so sketchy here.
No.
But here's what's on my mind. Is my top 10, and this is undisputed. Devin Shea, congratulations on getting married, but this is undisputed. My top 10 greatest hockey players of all time.
Hey,
could you
shut the sound off for the next 5 minutes? Delete this.
Number 10B of the greatest of all time, Mark Andre Fleury. How about number 10, Guy Lafleur? How about 9B, Evgeny Malkin? How about number 9, none other than Sidney Crosby? Number 8, Bobby Hall. Number 7, Phil Esposito. He got to be in there. How about number 6, Mark Messier?
Can't even pronounce his name.
Messier. How about number 5, Bobby Orr? I can pronounce that name. How about number 4? Yager's in there at number 4. A hint of Yager's none other than number 3, Gordie Howe. How about number 2? One of the greatest of all time, Mario Lemieux. How about 1B? Alexis Ovi. And number 1, Wayne Gretzky. Number 1, Wayne Gretzky. Number 1B, Ovi. And that's what's on my mind, the top 10 hockey players of all time.
Jim, your top 10 list of the greatest hockey players only displays your ignorance for the game of hockey.
Really?
Yeah, you didn't
that's
even.
That's a tight list.
What'd you do? Would you go to Wikipedia and just get the names?
You don't think Ovechkin should be up there?
Not even close.
Wow.
Not even close.
Devin Shea shaking his head. See, that's a good list. He said no.
Well, you know, just to throw mud all over his list, you know, there's been plenty of great hockey players. And, you know, one and two are always going to be Gretzky and Gordie Howe. And everybody else takes a back seat to those two.
Even over Murray.
But let's talk about goaltenders, okay? You've got Ken Dryden. You've got Terry Sawchuk. You've got Patrick Waugh. You've got Martin Brodeur, who Marc-Andre Fleury couldn't carry their athletic supporters.
The one that took the expansion team all the way to the championship.
But didn't win it, did he?
Okay. Three-time Stanley Cup champ.
How about Andre the Rocket Richard, who won the scoring titles
with them?
Jean Beliveau. Okay. How about Stan Mikita?
He should have been.
Tony Esposito. Okay.
The list goes on and on.
There.
Who would I move out though? I can't move nobody out.
Give me a magic marker. Give me a magic marker. I'll put the bums on the garbage pile where they belong. Now Mario Lemieux is definitely top 5. No question about it. But in my opinion, and it's just my humble opinion, anybody that's still an active player has no business being on an all-time greatest list. Because their legacy has not been
good point.
Made yet, you know. You become one of the all-time greats by the work of your career. That's my humble opinion. But
I appreciate Smoking Jim. Are you done?
Yes, sir.
So, I told them to cut that.
So
they didn't.
So what's on my mind?
What's on your mind, Chip Hayner?
What's on my mind? And what's on my mind is it's one of my favorite times of the year. We're working our way up to the Fall Classic. So far, 3 of the first rounds of the playoffs have been determined.
Yeah.
The Milwaukee Brewers swept out the Colorado Rockies. And what did the Rockies do? They eliminated the Cubs. Oh, poor babies. the Atlanta Braves bowed down to the L.A. Dodgers last night, 3-1. You've got the Boston Red Sox up 2-1 on the New York Yankees after the dismantling of the Yankees last night. But the great thing about baseball, today's a new game.
Yes, sir.
The score starts out 0-0. Yeah. Anything can happen. You know, it's a 5-game series. First team to win 3. And then you've also got the Houston Astros, who completely destroyed the Cleveland Indians. And I think the Indians' days, you know, most teams that get a chance to stay at the top, you give them about 3 years, and then what's going to happen is the skill level is going to start diminishing, people are going to start moving. And, if Cleveland didn't play in such a bad division, I think Cleveland and the division that Cleveland played in, they were the only team over 500.
Right.
Yeah, they may have a chance to win another division next year, but.
It's possible.
It's possible, but they're Cleveland. just like that, they lost to the Cubs in 7 games. But I love the baseball at this time of the year. Some amazing things happened, which I shall go over in my trivia segment. Things that have happened, well, one thing happened only once before in the history of Major League Baseball. And last night something happened that never happened before.
Amazing.
And that's what we call a tease. So that's what's on my mind.
All right.
Thanks for the tease, and thank you, Chip Hayner. Appreciate that. And thanks for trying to help Smoking Jim Frazier, because he was really lost.
I like my list.
Well, it's totally made up, like most of the stuff that you do. And the facts, we need 17 sources. You can't even give us one source. We're going to move on. I got to think what's on my mind. Oh, what's on my mind is the Penguins started the season, beat the Caps, great game, 7-6. Then the Canadians come in. They look like a superstar team. I don't even want to talk about it. One of the worst hockey games that I watched. Just terrible. So we'll see what happens Thursday night when they play the Golden Knights. Smoking Jim will be there cheering on Marc Andre Fleury.
He won't be playing.
No. What happened?
Fleury won't be playing. Murray won't
that.
Be playing.
Murray, I know. Murray's concussed.
Yeah. Well, Fleury won't be playing either. So everybody that paid all that money to see Marc Andre play, well, you'll get to see
What's wrong with
him? Smoking Jim's not going now.
Because Murray always hurt, but what's wrong with him?
Murray's concussed. I don't know what Fleury's injury is, but
he heard you were coming to the game, so he boycotted it. He boycotted. He goes, he doesn't even know football, let alone hockey. What the heck? And then he tries the Buffalo people on baseball when he's asking how far out were the Pirates on the wild card. Who even asked that question? They had a winning record. Oh, my mind. What's on your mind? That's on my mind because he brought that up. And then the other thing on my mind, since these guys like to put three, four things out there, I'll go to a third thing. What happened to the Pittsburgh Steelers defense?
Wow.
They played defense. You got Watt being a superstar again. They got him rushing two games in a row, and it worked this week. Mm-hmm. They sent him every which way but loose, and he performed. And we even had some defensive plays and pressure and hurries on the quarterback, on a good quarterback. Matt Ryan is a good quarterback. Mm-hmm. He's a known choker, but, you know, those things happen from the Super Bowl and other stuff. But he does throw the ball pretty good and get some yardage, and they shut him down, 17 points. Can't beat that.
Mm-mm.
And for us to score like that, I was duly impressed with the game. It was great Steeler football. Are they back? I don't know. Can you do it two in a row?
Well, that's what I want to see, if T.J. Watt can show up two games in a row.
Well, he's the greatest linebacker that Smoking Jim, who's been a scout for so many years, he won't tell us.
Well, he has six.
That he's ever seen.
He's had six sacks, and he got those in two games, and there was three games where I had to search for his statistics because I didn't.
You didn't see him?
Yes, exactly.
Understood. But Smoking Jim says he's the best he's ever seen. Hall of Famer.
White power.
Unbelievable how he discovered it. This is what's on my mind, and we'll be back with some fiction and fact from Smoking Jim's Almanac. Hi, Bethel Park. Uncle Al speaking. I'm asking you to come help us behind the scenes at BP TV. We're looking for some proud Bethel Park residents to help us make the shows that you want to watch. For more information, contact Station Director Dave Cable, and we will see you behind the cameras at BP TV.
Hey, it's Christine from Bethel Park Library. I want to tell you about a great fundraiser we have going on. You can take home a print of this cute sloth, painted by local artist Maria Prasik, was inspired by Vivian, the sloth that lives at the National Aviary. The original painting will be housed at the Bethel Park Library forevermore, but you can own a 16 by 20 print for $50. You can purchase it at the Bethel Park Public Library or through the library's website at bethelparklibrary.org.
Machine. Thanks, Chipper. Thanks, Devin Shea, who came here from his honeymoon to be with us. And how about the double backflip by the Gateway Gator, Zach Taylor?
Not a double backflip. Just a backflip. It was a backflip.
A backflip? That was awesome. I got it on tape. Anybody want to see it, it'll be on my Facebook page under the Gateway Gator's website. But what's on my mind is a bit of bad news. Good friend of mine gave me a call and wanted to have dinner, but I had to turn him down. Isaiah
Thomas. You never
miss
a free meal.
Isaiah Thomas, former two-time world champion in Indiana Hoosier and Detroit Piston and NBA Hall of Fame. I told him, I said, I'm committed to El Levine, the Talking Machine, on Tuesday evening, so...
You mean the guy that rode on Dennis Rodman's coattail?
Yeah, there you go. The captain of the Detroit Pistons.
And the Bruce Brothers.
So I told him if he can commit to meet me before 3 o'clock.
Well, you got a show tomorrow.
I'll go to dinner.
You got a show tomorrow he's flying on PCTV.
He's flying out to Boston tonight in the New Hampshire. So we got together today at 3 o'clock and... He's in great shape. Good to see him. And I haven't seen him in over 10 years.
Wow.
And
what did he say about you?
Well, you know what? He was trying to
put his arms around you?
Be a vegetarian. Mm-hmm. But that didn't stop me from getting a steak. I hurt his pocketbooks a little bit, but he's doing very well. Got several different businesses. But I had to ask him, I says, give me something that I can put on my sports show tonight. I says, in your opinion, who was the greatest basketball player you ever seen, not counting yourself?
Oscar Robertson.
Well, before he said that, he says, you know what, Smoking Jim? He says, something I never told you before.
Uh-uh.
He says.
So he'll tell everybody.
He says, up until ninth grade, he says, I didn't play in ninth grade, but he said, up until ninth grade, he says, I wanted to play in the NFL. And he says, I wanted to be the next Lynn Swann.
Wow.
And I told him, I said, you look like Lynn Swann with the dimples and all that and the fake smile and all that, you know, give her. But good dude. But I asked him, who's the greatest basketball player you've ever seen? Not counting yourself. He says, well, it's not Michael Jordan. He says, LeBron James is better than Jordan. That's what he said. Now, you know, him and Jordan never got along.
Right.
Is that why he wasn't on the Dream Team?
The second one. He was on the first Dream Team. But they shut Jordan out on that one, and Jordan got pissed off. But they never liked each other. But he says, the greatest of all time is Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. He said he never lost in high school, never lost in grade school. He only lost one time in college at UCLA, and he got 6 world championships, and he was unstoppable. So... I didn't want him to cut my meal. I was only halfway done with my steak. But I wanted to say Will Chamberlain was much better than Kareem.
Well, he wasn't.
Huh?
No, he wasn't.
100 points in one game.
Nobody saw that season,
he averaged 50 points and 30 rebounds.
3 national titles at UCLA. World championships. And as a pro, his skyhook was unstoppable.
Well, Wilt's the only one that's ever blocked it, and he blocked it several times.
Mm-hmm.
Several times. Mm-hmm. He used to eat him
up. The only place Wilt beat him was with the ladies.
Well, that counts too. But hey, that's what's on my mind. Thanks for the dinner, Isaiah Thomas. See you next time you come to town.
Who's the all-time leading scorer in the NBA?
All-time in the NBA?
Mm-hmm.
Should be Kareem.
Case closed.
Yeah.
Case closed.
He knew the answer, well, buddy. That's why I asked you.
Who had the best single season in NBA history?
Did he win a championship?
Did he win a championship? Well, let me ask you this. Who changed the game of basketball? They changed so many rules
because they got beat by the Celtics.
There's 100 rules that they changed in basketball
You and I have to beg to differ, because I don't feel that you're great unless you, in your season that you claim greatness in, you don't win the championship.
73-9, brother. That refutes your argument right there.
No, it doesn't, because they didn't win the
championship.
Let me ask you this.
The greatest foul shooter in NBA history was Will Chamberlain. Never missed a foul shot.
Mm-hmm.
Till they changed the rules.
I'll fact check that.
He used to take off from the foul line and dunk it, and they changed the rules. You can't do that. Yeah, they changed the rules. 100 rules they changed for Wilt, changed 0 for Kareem.
Wow.
But that's what's on my mind. Fiction and fact from Smoking Jim's Almanac. Thanks, Isaiah Thomas, class act.
Can we get some fact checking on whether he was in town or not?
He used to date my cousin when he was at Indiana.
Is this a real cousin?
Yeah, good looking girl.
Or one of those made up cousins?
I think that's why he called me, to see if he could hook up. No.
I've met 60 of those cousins. They're not even related to you, told me. We just do that. I'm checking on you. Thank you, Smoking Jim Frazier.
Well, good evening, everybody, and get back to what I said about the
tease.
What happened in baseball last night that has never happened in the history of baseball. And this is a testament to people that say that the Pirates don't develop talent. Well, they do develop talent. It just ends up maturing somewhere else. But first, to speak to Jim's comment about Gerrit Cole. Gerrit Cole did something on Saturday that's only happened one other time in the history of Major League Baseball. In the playoffs, Gerrit Cole struck out 12 batters and did not walk any. And there was one other pitcher in the history of baseball that did that. Would you know who that might be?
Vada Blue?
Tom Seaver, 1973.
Wow. What year was that,
Tate? You got the same wrinkled shirt on.
Yeah.
I let Chip say that.
So
that just came out of the closet.
So anyhow, Gerrit Cole, second player in the history of Major League Baseball to strike out 12 batters in a playoff game without walking a single batter. The other person that did that, Tom Seaver, 1973, as a member of the New York Mets. Mm-hmm. So that happened on Saturday night. But last night, a former Pirate, who now plays for the Boston Red Sox, Brock Holt, is the first player in Major League history to bat for the cycle in a playoff game.
And you learned about the cycle earlier this year, Smoking Jim.
And here's the interesting thing about his cycle. In the ninth inning, while Aaron Boone, who is the manager of the New York Yankees, was getting roundly booed by the fans of the New York Yankees in their home stadium, put a position player in to pitch, and Brock Holt hit a home run to complete the cycle in the ninth inning.
Wow.
Off of a position player,
wow,
not a pitcher. So, interesting little tidbit there. But, you know, because we're into the playoffs right now, I kind of pulled out some statistics from some of the all-time single-season postseason pitching leaders, and I also have the postseason batting leaders.
Whoa.
Okay, so we're going to run through some quick statistics of some players that did some pretty significant things when it was all on the line. The lowest earned run average for a career for a player in the playoffs is none other than future Hall of Famer and the last person to wear Jackie Robinson's number in Major League Baseball, Mariano Rivera, His ERA was 0.7, and he did that over 141 innings pitched.
Wow.
So this wasn't a, a one-hit wonder.
Yeah.
Yes. Win and loss percentage for the career in the playoffs goes to no other than the famous Lefty Grove, who had a winning percentage of 1,000 in the playoffs. Never lost a game. The lowest earned run average for a season in the playoffs. Quite a number of players here have tied this.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and this is for one playoff season. Okay, mm-hmm. The list of zero earned runs with a minimum of, 15.2 innings pitched. But Wade Hoyt with 27 innings pitched with an ERA of zero. Christy Mathewson with over 27 innings pitched with an ERA of zero. Kenny Rogers in 2006 for the, I believe, the Texas Rangers.
Get on.
His ERA was zero after 23 innings pitched. Matt Cain, San Francisco Giants.
Wow.
Zero ERA over 21.1 innings pitched. Carl Hubble in 1933.
Oh, yeah.
You remember that, Smoking Jim.
Innings pitched. Zero ERA. Mike Boddicker, who was pitching for the Baltimore Orioles at the time, 1983. A zero ERA over 18 innings pitched. Then there is, this one happened in a season when the Pirates won the World Series. None other than the great Whitey Ford. Mm. Had an ERA of zero over 18 innings pitched. Still lost the series.
Whitey was tough. So,
Pedro Martinez in 1999, an ERA of zero and 17 innings pitched. Then there was Iron Joe McGinty.
Whoa.
Okay, 1905 with a zero ERA. And Duster Males in 1920, over 15.2 innings pitched. Most wins in a career for the playoffs, none other than Andy Pettitte of the New York Yankees.
Get on.
19 wins over 276.2 innings pitched.
Wow.
And wins in a season in the playoffs. Happened in 2001, happened in 2002. Randy Johnson with 41.1 innings pitched. And Francisco Rodriguez with 5 wins over 18.2 innings pitched. So now we're going to go to some batting feats. And there's, believe it or not, there's a Pirate in here.
Really?
Oh, yes, there is. The highest batting average for a career, player named Bobby Brown, 439 batting average and 46 plate attempts. Mm. Slugging percentage for career, Colby Rasmus with a slugging percentage of 1.038 and 35 plate attempts. Games played in a career. Future first ballot Hall of Famer Derek Jeter.
Whoa.
158 with 734 plate appearances.
Wow.
Now, batting average for a season happened in 1992. Former manager of the Pittsburgh Pirates, Lloyd McClendon, batting average of 727 for the playoffs, 16 plate attempts.
Oh. Wow.
Slugging percentage for a season goes back to 1928. The Iron Man Lou Gehrig himself, 1.727 in 17 plate appearances.
Wow.
On base percentage for his career, again, it's Colby Rasmus. He had a good playoff career. One year he got hot. His on base percentage was 571 in 35 plate appearances. His on base slugging for his career was 1.610.
Wow.
And on-base percentage for a season, once again, we go back to 1992, and the man that stole first base from the umpire, former manager of the Pittsburgh Pirates, Lloyd McClendon, and the career base plus slugging season, Lou Gehrig, 1928 again, 2.433 at 17 plate appearances.
Wow.
Where's Reggie Jackson at?
Mr. October.
Apparently, he didn't make the list. Apparently, he didn't
Chip
make the list.
Chip has a current list, Smoking Jim, unless
you
can find another
one. This is from Baseball Reference, so this isn't from,
Smoking Jim.
Yeah, Mr. Magoo's.
Give him 10 minutes. He can come up with something.
Yeah. No, but they're very, some very interesting facts. And, you know, like I said, I love watching the playoffs. Never know what's going to happen when you play baseball game. Oh, let me take you back. We're going to go back in the Wayback Machine, okay?
Uh-oh.
October 8th, 1956. Something that hasn't been done before or since. First and only perfect game pitched in the World Series by
Don Larson.
Yes, sir. Yankees beat the Brooklyn Dodgers.
Sandy Koufax.
Never did it in the World Series.
What? Where are you making that stuff up?
You sure?
Sandy Koufax threw 4 no-hitters in his career.
Not in the...
Okay? Never in the playoffs and never in a World Series. Mm. It's been done once, October 8th, 1956.
Garrett Cole may do it again.
I doubt it because let me tell you what happens. The way the game of baseball is played now, mm-hmm. they're not going to let a starting pitcher go past 7 innings.
They're bringing relievers to start games now.
Yes.
Did you know that?
No. It's a different
game. You missed
game. That. A quality start now is anything over 5 innings. And, you know, that's baseball's become a different game.
As we know it, not for you, though. It hasn't changed a bit. It's still exciting. It's an adventure. Thank you, Chip Hayner.
I wish I had some film of my pony leg pitching.
On location, what a night. I set a record for cancellations. I had 7 guests cancel. That's why I don't mention who's coming to the show. But I had 7 cancellations last night. We had 2 great guests, Mike Draculich and his wife, Deanna. They ended up handling the show at Olive Oil's Pizzeria. We had them as our only 2 guests, and they did a great job. Matter of fact, Deanna sells some products called Nerium. And Smokin' Jim suffers memory loss from CTE and numerous stories that he makes up. So she gave him some stuff to help him out. It'll help his mitochondria and telomeres. He thinks I'm making that stuff up. Get your funkin' waggles out and look that up. Mitochondria is in every cell that you have, and telomeres too. So, and she got him some healthy products. He scooped them right up. The black chew thing is for sleeping. And the yellow ones for when
sunshine.
You get up in the morning, mm-hmm. just like your shirt.
That's it.
You must have ate one and put the shirt on. It gave you guidance in that massive closet of yours. Unbelievable. We had a great show. We'll be back November 12th at Olive Oil's Pizzeria, 930 Brookline Boulevard. Always great food. People were coming in left and right. A couple new employees there helped us out and just had a great show. Thanks to Jeff, our cameraman, for getting that show and taking the pictures there. It was a fun night. Only 2 guests, but we made the most out of those 2 guests. So it happens there, and we'll have more guests for the next show. I promise you that. So that's my on-location report, and we'll be back.
When's
with
boxing?
Some October 26th. We'll be doing the Market Square. I just sent the information to the other Jimmy at 3rd Avenue. He said he was supposed to talk to Jimmy Savetic today. So who knows what we'll be doing. But he said he wants us to do the fights.
Okay.
So we're still on for that in Market Square, October 26th. It's a Friday night. So check us out there. The Market Square is always crowded on a Friday night, and hopefully the weather will be good. It was beautiful today, summer-like day. But Friday, we'll be complaining because it's going to be 55 degrees. So if you're not complaining in Pittsburgh, you're not from Pittsburgh. That's
what'd you
how
eat
I look
at the
at
wedding?
It.
What was at the wedding? What'd you eat there on location?
Some of the best meatballs that I've ever eaten in my life.
You mean at Devin's wedding? The food was excellent.
They melted in your mouth.
Wow.
And the cookie table was unbelievable.
I almost didn't get up from the cookie table.
Yeah. Chip went in. Stephanie went in. I had to show them up. I loaded my plate up. There was no room for a double layer of everything I put on there.
Really?
Yeah. No, I broke my diet and dived right in.
They did a really nice job in that. And Devin and his beautiful wife, it was a great night for them.
Great wedding at reception at level 20.
Beautiful bride.
Yes.
She was gorgeous.
Danny was. And she even asked me about Smokin' Jim, and I said, he will not be here. Everybody, I told him. They asked me straight up, and I said, he's my brother from another mother. He's not going to be here.
I was so close to coming.
You weren't. You weren't.
You got some explaining to do.
Put it like this. He can't explain his way out of it. His business partner, Aaron Ward, was so disappointed. Chip's wife, Stephanie's a friend of ours.
I love
smoking Jim. She got a text from him and goes, I can't even believe this. She was in utter shock. And Chip goes, well, at least you got a text. I got nothing back from him. So, I mean, that's what we had to deal with. And sorry, we diverted a little bit on location, but we did have different locations. Check me out on the 14th, that Sunday. I'll be at the Bethel Park Historical Society grand reopening. I think it's in the afternoon, so come see me there.
And I'm coming to see you on the 18th. We can talk about that next week.
Well, we can talk about the 18th, but Smoking Jim's not coming to see me. He already had an appointment at PCTV. I don't even know what the place is called. They told me it used to be a mall there, Allegheny Mall.
Okay.
That hasn't been there for years. What's the name of the place?
I don't know.
Apollo something or other.
I don't know. I'm going to ride in with you.
No, you're not. We don't live near each other. You ain't coming to get me. No doubt about it. But we'll see what happens. I got two shows that are up for awards. If you can vote, start plunking.
I'm already stuffing the ballots for you, buddy.
You're not even. You don't even have a vote. I already heard that. See, I already know. I set you up. You got no vote in this. Sorry, folks. We diverted. We're going to come back, and we're going to talk some Steelers.
Yes, sir.
One of the things we do at BPTV is encourage our producers to film on location. Not only does shooting on location give our producers the opportunity to take advantage of their subject matter, filming in different locations gives each program its own distinct flavor. This also helps anyone who's flipping through the channels avoid confusion when they turn on BPTV. With around 500 programs produced at BPTV each year, the last thing we want people to think is that we're only broadcasting one program. So, you need to come into BPTV to pitch your TV show, but in terms of where you actually end up taping your show, the sky's the limit.
Scout is trustworthy,
loyal,
helpful,
friendly,
courteous,
kind,
obedient,
cheerful,
thrifty,
brave,
clean,
and reverent.
Sorry, folks. Live TV, we were just cracking a funny joke with Smoking Jim Frazier. Always something going on, but the Steelers, I just alluded to that.
You know what? I gotta compliment you on your black lipstick.
Yeah.
I enjoyed that.
That's not a shadow, people.
Believe me. It goes with my shirt, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
No, I wanted that on the Pit Gold. That's Bethel Bakery's Pit Gold, and that's PITTGOLD, like Smoking Jim's light pit gold shirt.
So let's talk Pittsburgh Steelers. So The Steelers surprised all of us this past weekend, and it looks like they actually played defense this week against the top offense. The last two games that the Falcons had played, which they both lost, they scored 37 and 36 points. So their offense was one of the top offenses. They got Julio Jones, who arguably is
one of the top receivers.
One of the top receivers, as well as AB. The Calvin Ridley, young kid they got from Alabama, seems to be lighting up the things. They got Sanu. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And, so they got a great running back. Devontae Freeman came back. And pretty much Julio Jones, until the fourth quarter, hadn't caught a pass the whole game. Joe Hayden.
Shocking. He shut him down.
Joe Hayden shut him down. They did a really nice job. But I think the key to them being able to derail the Falcons' offense was the pressure they put on
There's no doubt the
Matt
pressure,
Ryan.
The hurries that they caused, the pressure they caused him not to have a spot to throw from.
Well, it blew his timing, because the Steelers
didn't have a spot.
The Steelers went after him like they were hungry. Even Cam Haywood was in there applying pressure, and T.J. Watt had a great game. A great game.
No doubt about it.
And what was that kid's name? Fort? Recovered a fumble in the end zone to finish off the scoring,
How about Dirty Red? 44 had a great game.
Well, Ford and Medakovich were splitting time at the inside linebacker position, filling in for Vince Williams. And I think what they had talked about during the week was that they simplified the calls on defense because, if you've got it too complex, people,
yeah, but here's the difference.
People need to be able to just react to
Hold
the ball
there's
instead
one,
of
here's one
wondering
key
where
thing.
They're
I
supposed
to be. I happened to be listening to the fan yesterday, and they said it must be ironic that they communicated better with Vince Williams. Mm-hmm. Vince Williams and Shazier were a good combination. Vince Williams getting the defense set, I always noticed some difficulties with a couple players, like fine-tuning it, the couple of the safeties don't come in, or there's always something a little bit off with his calls.
But, I think also they'd also mentioned that they were, for lack of a better way of putting it, dumbing down the defense because, if the right hand doesn't know what the left hand's doing, you're going to give up big plays. You're going to get a lot of points scored against you.
What do they tell you in football? You should react, not think.
And if they're wondering where you're supposed to be instead of, reacting to where the ball is.
That's part of it. And with Vince Williams not being in there, maybe it's true, maybe it's not.
Dirty Red's a great player.
But I like Medakovich. I wonder why he's not in there more.
Because he got
he was
red
hurt
hair
last year.
No, I think he spent a lot of time injured.
Yeah, he was injured last year.
He ain't been injured this year.
No, I was saying with last year he should have been in more, but he was injured when Shazier went out. So he had some injuries.
The biggest prejudice you're going to see in the National Football League is people against red hair. That's why Andy Dalton, all he does is win, but they don't like him. He's not an elite quarterback because of his red hair.
You want to know another reason why he's not an elite quarterback?
Because they're four.
How many playoff games has he won? That's what I thought.
Quit stumping, smoking, Chip. You're like a lawyer. The lawyers ask questions they know answers
to. Drew Brees hasn't won many playoff games.
Except the Super Bowl, right? Against Peyton Manning.
He was always considered great even before he won any playoff game. And Andy don't, but see, Drew Brees don't have a red hair.
And congratulations, by the way, to Drew Brees for breaking the NFL all-time career yardage record for passing. Passed up Peyton Manning last night, and he did it in grand fashion on a 68-yard touchdown pass.
Yeah.
Wasn't it ridiculous stopping the game for something like that? Come on, play
not
the game,
all.
Man.
Not at all. Not at all, man.
Come on.
I thought it was great.
I would have made
prejudiced.
Him forfeit it.
I think that's prejudiced.
I thought it was great. His three sons were on the field
no place
with his
of
daughter.
Football for that.
That was excellent.
They handed the ball right off to the guy from the Hall of Fame. And did you notice he had white gloves on when they handed him the ball?
Yeah, I see that.
That ball went right to Canton is where that ball is
right
now.
That's what it should be.
Yeah.
What an accomplishment. There's a guy that had a torn up shoulder and
Toyed up shoulder, and you know, and he ended up, they ended up drafting Phillip Rivers and cutting loose Drew Brees. And you know what?
And he only had a 25% chance to succeed. And look how hard he worked to succeed.
And isn't the prototype quarterback in the NFL 6'5", 245 pounds? Yeah. Oh, yeah. And Drew Brees, if he's 6', if he's 6', I'll eat my hat.
He's 5'11".
And, yeah, and he somehow finds the way to get the ball to the receivers. He opens up passing lanes. You know, so you don't have to be 6'5", 6'6", to be a great quarterback in the NFL.
Well, no matter what, the MVP of the league this year is going to be the kid from Kansas City. You got McCree.
Oh, interestingly enough.
He's 6'4", 6'5".
Pat Mahomes, his father.
Played for the Pirates.
Played for the Pirates from 2006 until 2011. Paul Mahomes.
Pirates didn't know he was black.
And a left-handed starter, and he pitched very well for the Pirates. I saw him pitch a number of times at PNC Park. But, yes, his father played for the Pittsburgh Pirates from 2006 to 2011. So that means his son was raised here in Pittsburgh.
Born on a hill like
this. There you
go.
See that?
I didn't know that.
We know how to breed them in Western PA, right?
It's the water.
This is where the quarterbacks come from. Joe Montana.
It's all the water.
Joe Namath. Jim Kelly.
How the sun gets so light, though?
It's in the water. Smoking Jim, he doesn't get the tan like you get. Is that a spray tan? Yeah,
nobody wants to answer my question.
Well, we're doing with Smoking Jim Frazier. How come we don't get mad when you don't answer our questions?
I'll tell you the reason why I'm not answering your question, because I want to be back next week.
Yeah. We're starting our eighth year next week. We might be leaving Smoking Jim Frazier.
I want to make it to 8 years in 1 week.
We might leave Smoking Jim off the set. How many stories can one man tell?
So, that being said, Vontaze Burfict has made it through 1 week of the NFL season without getting suspended. What's going to happen this week?
He's going after Juju.
Good. So maybe his next suspension will be a little bit longer than 3 games.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe Juju's last baby that he birthed it in.
I don't know. If my memory serves me correct, it was Juju that was standing over top of Vontaze, right?
Yeah.
He flattened him. He knocked him into next week.
But Sunday's a different day.
Yeah, well, you know what, though? The Steelers, I really feel that this week is definitely a must-win, and the Steelers got to play better than they played last week if they expect to be in Cincinnati.
They do. They need that. Well, we're just about out of time. We got about 50 seconds left to go. Smoking Jim Frazier, you got anything else to add to while you're wearing that colorful gold? You guys got the gold shirts going. I got the gold cake. Gold.
Let me make a mention. This weekend, I will be doing the walk to end Alzheimer's Saturday morning down at Heinz Field. Alan and myself both believe in very heartily.
Sure.
And one day, and I hope this will happen in my lifetime, they will see the person with the white flower. Yeah. That would be the first survivor.
That would be great. We can only hope to that. And thanks for watching our 7th anniversary Pittsburgh Sportsline TV show. I'm so proud of that. And thank you for watching and all the great feedback. And please stay Joey Strong.